students, welcome back to your English class. Students, today we will do chapter number 6 of our grammar book, and that is masculine and feminine nouns. Masculine and feminine, we have done this part in our course book chapter also. Do you remember? Yes. Can anyone tell me what is masculine noun and what is feminine noun? So students, let us repeat. What are masculine nouns? Nouns that stand for boys, men or male animals are called nouns of the masculine gender. Means male nouns are called masculine nouns, like son, father, tiger. These are masculine nouns. Now, feminine nouns. Nouns that stand for girls, women or female animals are called the nouns of the feminine gender. Means, female nouns are called feminine nouns, like daughter, mother, tigress. These are the nouns in the feminine gender, right? Students, here are some masculine and feminine nouns. Let us learn. Hero, heroine. Emperor, empress. Emperor means king. Wizard, witch. Wizard means a man who has magical powers. Fox, vixen. Drake, duck. Lord, lady. Lord means a noble man. Bull, cow. Gander, goose. Bird, a type of bird it is. Tiger, tigress. Monk, nun. Monk is a man of a religious community, means sadhu. Duke, duchess. Duke means ruler. Husband, wife. Sir, madam. Waiter, waitress. Students, let us do some book work now. Exercise A. Replace each masculine noun with a feminine noun in these sentences. Remember to make other necessary changes. Students, there are some sentences given and we have to replace masculine nouns with feminine nouns. Like number 1. The boys waited for their father. Boys and father are masculine nouns, so we will change them. It will be the girls waited for their mother. Number 2. My mother won an award for her poems. Students, in this sentence there is no masculine noun, so this sentence will be written as it is. Number 3. My uncle has 3 horses. Students, in this sentence there are 2 masculine nouns, uncle and horses. So after replacing the masculine nouns with feminine nouns, the sentence will be, my aunt has 3 mares. Aunt is a feminine gender for uncle and mare for horse. Students, in this way you can complete this exercise. Look at the 8th sentence. This is my brother. He loves reading novels. The sentence after replacing will be, this is my sister. Now, not he. For girls, we use she. She loves reading novels. Right? Now, try to complete this exercise and then match it with the answer key. Read the nouns in this box, circle the masculine nouns and underline the feminine nouns. Let us start. Bat, chair, stick, mountain, computer, table, man. Man is masculine noun, therefore circle this. Clip, tree, star, woman is feminine noun, therefore underline this. Pen, glass, cup, balloon, phone, letter, pencil. Students, did you notice that apart from man and woman, none of these nouns can be classified as masculine or feminine? This is so because the rest of the nouns are non-living things.
Now, neuter gender. Nouns that are neither in the masculine gender nor in the feminine gender. Jo masculine gender mein bhi na ho, feminine gender mein bhi na ho. Those are the nouns that are in the neuter genders, like book, river, car, pencil, apple. So these are the nouns in the neuter gender. Okay, students?
Underline all the nouns in the neuter gender in this poem. See, students, here is a poem given. Now what you have to do, read this poem and underline the nouns in the neuter gender. You know what is neuter gender very well. Now do this exercise. This is your homework. Exercise C. In these sentences, mark the masculine nouns in red and the feminine nouns in green. Put a circle around all the nouns in the neuter gender. Students, here are some sentences given and what you have to do. You have to mark masculine nouns in red. जो भी nouns masculine gender के हैं उन्हें आपने red color से mark करना है. Feminine nouns के को green color में. And you have to put a circle all the nouns in the neuter gender. Neuter gender के nouns को आपको circle करना है. Okay? Like number one. Do you see that man in the blue suit? Students, here man is the noun in the masculine gender. So we will mark man in red color, right? In the blue suit. Suit here is neuter gender. So we will put a circle around suit. Number two. He is a well-dressed man, isn't he? Students, here man is the noun in masculine gender. Therefore, we will mark red color on it. Okay, number three. The woman in the blue sari beside him is his wife. Here, woman is the noun in feminine gender and sari is neuter gender and wife also in feminine gender. Number four. She is the headmistress of NBS school. Here, headmistress is feminine noun and NBS school is the noun in the neuter gender. Number 5. I have heard that they have a pet snake. Students, in this sentence, it is not mentioned whether the snake is a male or female. So, we will consider this in neuter gender, right? Number 6. Oh, really? My sister and I would love to have a pet parrot. Here, sister is feminine noun and parrot is the noun in the neuter gender because it is not mentioned whether it is male or female. Number 7. My mother says we don't have space for a cat or a rabbit. In this sentence, mother is the noun in feminine gender and cat and rabbit are the nouns in the neuter gender, right? Now, challenge time. There are 6 pairs of masculine and feminine nouns in this table. There are also 6 nouns from the neuter gender related to the pairs. Connect all 3 and mark them as M for masculine nouns, F for feminine nouns and N for nouns related to the neuter gender. One has been done for you. Students, as you can see in this table, there are 3 columns. In first column, there are masculine nouns and in second, there are feminine nouns. And in the third one, there are nouns related to the neuter gender. Now, what we have to do? We have to match them correctly. Like milkman, milkmaid and milk. Second is groom. We will match it with bride. Groom means dulha, bride dulhan. And In the neuter gender, we will match it with ring. Groom, bride, ring. Now, wizard. Wizard, witch. And in the neuter gender, we will match it with broom. Because wizards and witches use broom for riding. As you can see in the picture also. Broom means jhadu. Now, king, queen, crown. Now, stallion. Stallion means horse. So, we will match it with mare and stable. Stable is a place where horses live. And the last one, prince, princess, castle. Castle means mahal.
So, students, this was our chapter number 6. Okay, I hope you all have understood the chapter. Now, open page number 24 in your grammar book. Right, page number 24. Students, there is a paragraph given, my neighborhood park. So, first of all, we will read this paragraph. Right?
There is a beautiful park in my neighborhood. Neighborhood means locality or community around our homes. Means aas pados. Okay, it is large and covered with soft green grass. There are flowers of many kinds in the park. Many children come to play in the park every day. They like to play on the swings and the slides. Some elderly people visit the park too. They sit and watch the children at play. I love going to my neighborhood park.
Students, this paragraph is a descriptive paragraph. Descriptive is taken from describe. Means किसी चीज के बारे में बताना, describe करना, अच्छे से उसके बारे में हमें बताना, अपने views, अपने ideas, अपने thoughts रखना, right? So, in this paragraph, there is a description about a park. एक park के बारे में हमें बताया गया है. So, this paragraph is called descriptive paragraph. The first sentence of the paragraph is called topic sentence. First sentence से हमें पता चल रहा है कि ये paragraph एक park के बारे में है. Like, there is a beautiful park in my neighborhood. So, this sentence is called topic sentence. And after the first sentence, there is more information about the park. So, this is called the body of the paragraph, right? First sentence is called topic sentence, then body. And the last sentence of the paragraph is called closing sentence. जहां पे हमें अपने paragraph को end करना होता है, okay? This is called closing sentence, right?
Write a paragraph about a scene at the railway station. Use the ideas and words provided. First, make a plan for what you will write. Remember to include an introduction, a body, and a closing sentence. Students, now you have to write a descriptive paragraph on the topic, a scene at the railway station. Here are some questions given. By answering these questions, you can cover a lot of points. Like, why did you go to the railway station? आप railway station पर क्यों गए थे? Who were the people you saw there? What were they doing before the train arrived? Train आने से पहले लोग वहाँ पर क्या कर रहे थे? What happened when the train arrived? जब train आई तो क्या हुआ? When the train arrived, what did you do? जब train आई तो आपने क्या किया? What happened after it left? Or when it was leaving the station. Means, जब ट्रेन जा रही थी या चली गई थी, तब वहाँ क्या हुआ? Students, there are some hints also that you can use to write the paragraph. These hints will help you a lot to write the paragraph. Okay, now try to write the paragraph. See students, we can write the paragraph like this. One day, my family and I went to the railway station. First sentence is the topic sentence. Yes. We were waiting for the train to Hisar. We were going to visit our relatives. There were a few people sitting on the benches. Some stalls were selling tea, snacks, and newspapers. Suddenly, the train arrived and the platform became very noisy. people started boarding the train. I ran to sit by the window. The train began to move slowly and I could see the beautiful view from the window. We enjoyed our journey and reached after 2 hours. So students, this is the descriptive paragraph on the topic, a scene at the railway station, right?
So students, this was all about the chapter number 6 and the paragraph writing. Okay, now do the given work in book and notebook. Bye bye.